2012 is a big year. It's going to be an important year. We've got a lot of elections to win, one specifically important election to win. And I want to challenge you guys, that as we're the involved people in the political process, to not lose sight of what our legislators are doing in this coming year. Whether it's the folks that are going to be here here in a little bit that represent us in Atlanta, or if it's the folks in Washington. When I asked Joseph for a couple minutes, I didn't realize that Congressman Graves was going to be here to hear this. I promise you don't need to start working an exit strategy or anything. This isn't going to get awkward. It could, right? We're not going to let that happen. There are two issues that have been talked about in Washington recently, and I just want to kind of point your attention to it to reinforce the fact that we need to be paying very close attention to what's going on. In December, there was a bill that was passed by the House and the Senate called the National Defense Authorization Act. That bill did a number of things, but one of the things that it did was it authorized the indefinite detention of American citizens without charge or trial. Congressman Graves in the back there voted against this bill. I actually brought a quote that he put on his Facebook site. I loved this quote, so I wanted to read it. "Erring on the side of liberty and the Constitution, I voted no on the NDAA." And Congressman, I appreciate that. That was good. I can promise you, if you stand by the Constitution and stand on the side of liberty, you will have good people behind you every time. I am disappointed to let you know, though, that in the Senate, our senators voted for that bill. It was signed, it passed mid-December. It was signed by President Obama earlier this month. This last week, you may have seen something here or there on the internet about the Stop Online Piracy Act. That was a big deal. American citizens won a big victory this week. In the House, SOPA was the bill name, and it's been pulled. In the Senate on Friday, Harry Reid announced that he was taking it off the schedule. It was scheduled for a vote this coming Tuesday. My initial challenge when I was thinking through this was to challenge you to call Senators Isaacson and Chambliss this week, on Monday morning, because they were voting on that thing on Tuesday. On top of that, they were both co-sponsors of the bill. After Senator Reid pulled off the schedule, Senator Chambliss withdrew his co-sponsorship. I'll mention it again, Congressman Graves last Saturday, before any of that mess blew up, told me he was against that bill. It was a bill that had good intentions stated to stop piracy online, but really it was an internet censorship bill. So I use these two examples to tell you we can't just focus on the elections at hand. We need to make sure we keep an eye on what's going on. Call them. Call their offices. The people that answer the phones up there are very friendly. They're very courteous. It's easy. You call and you say, "Hi, I'm Ron," or use your name. You call and say, "Hi, I'm from Baldwin County, and I want to ask Congressman to vote against this bill," and they'll say, "Thank you for your support." And if you have some supporting arguments, you can offer that. But it's very easy to give feedback to your congressmen and your senators. I challenge you to do that and pay very close attention to what's going on this year. Thanks. Thank you.